So I've decided to that London to Brighton's not enough, so we needed to do an extra 9 miles or so. When points failure, well, actually, it was overhead cable failure,
overhead cables.
Not quite Reggie Perrin, prevented us from getting the train that we originally were going to get to. And so we had to cycle the extra 7 or 8 miles to Waterloo to get here. But anyway, we're here now.
It's a Reggie Perrin, it's overhead cables.
I'm Hazel, I'm co-founder of Way Out Arts, which is a charity in Sierra Leone that offers free training and facilities in music and the arts. We opened our first studio in 2012. We're really looking forward to having these guys. Last night a DJ over in Sierra Leone in November, and the guys there are already very excited about that, and I'm here just to wish good luck to the guys today. It's brilliant, and thank you very much.
How you doing? My name's Dean. I'm here with last night at DJ Save My Life. About to kill myself on the London to Brighton on this fag.
Right, the old Dean there in the background playing the tunage. That's how we roll here at last night at DJ. 60 mile ahead of us.
So good having all these team members last night DJ supporting us with their cycling tops on as well. So, you know, it's a good feeling, you know, with all these 37 riders we've got on board all putting themselves up for the challenge. And we've got 3 riders from Velo Ibiza coordinating it all. So far, so good. Over £7,000.
So far, so good. For us today, I'm really looking forward to it. It's been a nice, gentle ease into it.
Is this the Surrey Downs? Is this where we are? The Croydon Downs? For the Downs?
Some kind of Downs.
There's 40 of us out on what was a glorious day, doing it for all the gang over in Sierra Leone. We just had our second hardest climb, so I believe we still have the ditching beacon to go. But we're all here, we've all made it, bar a few punctures, and we're ready to go for a round 2.
Been definitely probably the most challenging bike ride. I'm not an avid cycler, but it's been good actually. I mean, so far so good. We've had that wasn't a very fun hill we just climbed up, but a little break now and then looking forward to getting back to it, I think.
And what's it like cycling with all your team buddies from Oyster?
I have to admit, that's actually quite fun. The only time I've ever really done biking before is, either to or from work back when I was a kid. And having a load of people around you gets you going a little bit more. And you feel like you're all sort of in it together. And it's a great cause, so, it's worth the pain.
Super.
How's that?
Oh my god, hardest thing I've ever done. But you know what, I'm fucking happy I did it. I had to stop a few times and catch my breath, but...
Me too.
Oh,
good man, well done.
All for a good cause,
All for a good cause.
Are we done now, is that it? Are we finished?
No, yeah, it's just...
It's downhill, right?
Downhill now.
Yay!
Right, so, we've beat the Ditchling Beacon. We've done it. Everybody has got up that one. And it was tough, but a great feeling when you get to the top of it, and a beautiful view. The lovely Joe, the photographer who donated her services kindly, was at the top, Joe Thorne, which I'm sure we're going to get some great images of that as well. But it's onwards, forwards, and we're going to be heading down to Hove Lagoon now. It's all downhill from here, and I think we're ready for this bit.